Hello everyone, today we will talk on center of gravity. If you have not yet subscribed the channel, please subscribe the channel to know about interesting facts and concepts of mechanical engineering which will help you in your vivas and interviews. Moving on to the topic, consider a body consisting of tiny particles having the weight dw. Now let us consider an axis. And the moment produced by this tiny weight dw will be written as the force dw into x, the perpendicular distance. Now, one must understand that dealing with so many tiny particles or tiny weights is somewhat difficult. So, for the sake of ease, I will assume one hypothetical resultant weight passing through a point on the body. So thus, this point becomes the center of gravity. And thus, I can conclude that center of gravity is a point on the body through which the hypothetical resultant weight of all these tiny particles passes through. And by the Varignon's theorem, which states that the moment of the resultant force is equal to the sum of the moments produced by the component forces, we can write this equation. That is, the moment produced by this resultant hypothetical weight will be equal to the moment produced by all these tiny particles. And we write this equation. This equation is used for locating the center of gravity. Further, weight can be written as mass into gravity. And we can cut this gravity and we write this equation. This equation is used for locating center of mass. And I would like to tell you that the center of mass and center of gravity are one and the same thing. And they both are the one and the same point. Further, mass can be written as volume into density. And this density can be cancelled. And we write this equation for the locating the centroid. Further, volume can also be written as area into x bar is equal to integration of x into dA. This integration of x into dA is a term called the first moment of area. Now further, I will have to conclude that the center of gravity deals with the distribution of weight. The center of mass deals with the distribution of mass and centroid deals with the distribution of area. Now, the centroid and center of gravity can be the same point if the mass is distributed evenly. If the mass is concentrated or more on one side, the center of mass will shift towards that side. If the weight is more on one side, the center of gravity will shift towards that side. If the area is more on one side, the centroid will shift towards that side. Thank you. This was all about center of gravity, centroid, and center of mass. Thank you.